Hi guys, Jay Smith here, down at Bury Golf Range in Suffolk, and today we're talking about balls. These ones. Now, I have been doing some interesting testing, some very long-winded testing, with a new manufacturer called Vice. Now, there's been a lot of talk about the ball market, about other manufacturers coming in, such as Kirkland, and all the fuss about Kirkland, with how they have come into the market with Costco, and then obviously selling out as much as they did. People have been doing tests on YouTube about the quality and the durability, etc. I found another manufacturer, Vice, and I was interested to see they're claiming that their range is equivalent to the Titleist Pro V1 and the Pro V1X and the, say, the DT Solo for the distance ball and the NXT Tour, etc. So everybody's range is no different to Shrixon's and everything else. So I thought it'd be a good idea to try and see if we can get a few and see if we can actually put these things down to the test. They've come in a lovely little selection box. So they look like that. Looks quite nice. So in here I've got the Pro Plus, the Pro. So the Pro Plus is the Pro V1X equivalent. The Pro is the Pro V1 equivalent. The Tour is like the NXT Tour. And the Drive is like the DT Solo. So like the distance one that's supposed to go out there as far as it can. Right, well, for myself, I use a Pro V1. Have done since the dawn of time, nearly. I think I'm as guilty as anyone else. Dropped on the bandwagon of tour players use it. It's the best known ball in golf, the most used on tour, most won tournament ball in golf, blah, da, da, da. So one thing you can do in the market of golf is use the same balls as the pros. So I've been guilty of doing the exact same thing. So when Vice have been saying these bits and pieces about they've made these balls to do this, that and everything else, I thought I'd give them a test. Now, just looking at a website for Vice, feel free to pop on their website and have a look, because there's lots and lots of gumph on there that you can read. Basically, like the Vice Pro, which is the Pro V1 equivalent, it's three-piece, like the Pro V1. Cast urethane cover for a gentle and responsive feel. I love what they've got on these things. They talk about dimple patterns and then optimizing distance, no different with the Pro Plus, which is the Pro V1X. Four-piece, like the Pro V1X is. Cast urethane cover, extreme soft feel, high-level durability, blah, blah, blah. Anyway, I have done all the testing for all of them, so if there is enough call for it, I will stick all the data. I'd either do another video or put all the data available so people can see what the drive ball did, the tour ball did. Now, I use the Pro, or the Pro V1, so I tested all the stuff on the Pro. Now, I actually done the test when I done both of them. I done the Pro and the Pro Plus, so Pro V1, Pro V1X. And apart from the driver, where I found that the Pro Plus, Pro V1X, it launched about a degree higher. That's the only thing. But the rest of it was, within reason, nearly identical. There was not enough really to be able to distinguish differences between the two balls. I would say feel-wise, the Pro, which is the Pro V1 equivalent, felt softer, and the Pro V1X felt harder, the Pro Plus felt harder like a Pro V1X. Yeah. To the point, I got three people and I blind test them, so I got one Pro V1 and Pro, Vice Pro, and set them down on the floor so you could not see what they were. So I got the writing in the right place, and got them to hit. Now, it was interesting that two out of the three called it wrong. They thought the Vice Pro was the Pro V1, so that's interesting. Right. All I'm going to do now, we're going to do a little cut towards what I did in the test, so you can see the effort that I put in, all the balls that I hit, etc. The clips speeded up, so you'll be able to see what I was doing. Hope you can see there that it was a lot of work. That was all the stuff on the simulator. I've got even more stuff here on GC2 on the app, all closed data, so we can see how they work. Now, again, this is for the Pro only, the Vice Pro, because that's what I use. I use a Pro V1, so the same ball from Vice is the Pro. So I used my 7-iron, no, 6-iron, did I lie? 6-iron. The reason I did, I used driver, 6-iron and my 58. My 6-iron is about 32 degrees, my 58 is obviously 58, and my driver is 8 degrees. And I'm trying to think about what I could use that could be half decent gaps. So obviously with 32 and 58 you've got 26, and 32 minus 8 you've got 24, yeah, something like that. So you've got 2 degrees difference. So I'm trying to get a decent gap in to see if things correlate. Now, interesting, we'll go for the 6-iron first. So beware, we're talking data now, let's crunch some numbers, let's delve into the difference between the Pro V1 and the Pro. And I will say this, I've done the same test when it comes to the Pro V1X and the Pro Plus, and the results, what I'm going to give you, are exactly the same, which is very interesting. So MP57 6-iron, which is what I've got, on the Vice Pro, I hit seven shots and average 118, launch angle 17.8, left and right, that's me, so 1.2 right, 1.6 left, just little draws, that's me, so don't worry about that too much. When it comes to the backspin, 4880. Now, I don't spin the ball as much as I would like, so hence the reason why I've gone for the Pro V. It's a bit softer. It feels, when I've done the test, there's not really much difference anyway, but I get the best numbers from a Pro V. It's so tiny, I could use both, so I just like the feel better of a Pro V. Peak height 31, which is give or take where I naturally hit. Descent angle 45 degrees. Which is a nice, healthy descent angle for my 6-iron spinning at that amount. I've got a chance for it stopping the other end. And carry distance 172. And if you're interested, dispersion 1.5 yards offline. Don't worry about dispersion. Dispersion is only, it's just completely me. Right, let's go to the MP57 6-iron again with the Pro V1. Now, 7 shots again. Average ball speed 118. Same as the Vice Pro. Launch angle, 18 degrees, 0.2 of a degree above the Vice Pro. So well within my limitations of strike. Side angle, 0.3 right, 1.7 left, tiny little draws again. Backspin, 4774 to 4880, which is like 106 RPM, which is so tiny. Can we really see a difference? You could argue, looking at the numbers, I got one on the Vice Pro up at 5375, but that was more of a strike situation than it was anything to do with the ball, because if that was the ball, all the rest of them would be going exactly the same. So it's my variation in strike which caused that slight deviation. Pro V1, again, 106 revolutions in it. Peak height, 31.2. So 0.2 of a yard higher, 0.2. 45.1 degrees. Now, that's 0.1 of a degree in descent angle steeper than the Vice Pro. Now, I'd like to say before I do this, I'm not sponsored by Vice or anything else like that. At the time of this video, I am not sponsored by them at all. So it is just a case of, I thought it'd be interesting to see if we can prove what Vice are saying. Bearing in mind, these Vice balls, the Pro and the Pro Plus, are as little as £1.79 per ball, where you're looking at the Pro V1 and Pro V1X is about double that. Interesting. So, back to the numbers. Carry distance in yards, 172. Exactly the same as the Vice Pro. And dispersion's 1.4 yards offline. Don't worry about that. That's me. So, basically what we're saying is with a 6-iron, they both travel the same. They both go the same speed. They both launch the same. They both basically spin the same. Go the same height. Descend the same. They're the same. Right. Let's go 58. Now I hit 4 shots with each. Let's go to the Vice Pro first, my Vokey 58 degree. Ball speed 80 miles an hour. Launch angle 32.5. Side angle, side spin, that's 1.4, 4.7, little draws again. Backspin is at 9.437. So we're getting picky now, 9.437. Peak height of meters is 25.7, descent angles 51.6, and carrying yards was 93. Now, that is basically where I carry my 58 degree anyway, and then 0.7 yards off left. Don't worry about that. That's dispersion again. That's me. Pro V1, going up against this one. Now, this is where we're going to see the biggest difference. If there is a difference, we're going to see the biggest difference now when you've got a lot of loft on. This is where we see the massive difference. 79 miles an hour ball speed. So 1 mile an hour in it. That is it. Now, so that could be a slight difference in strike. I would say that's more to do with slight difference in strike than it is anything else. 32.1 launch angle, so 0.4 of a degree lower. 0.4. There's nothing in it. 32.2, 6.8, that's just me, little draw again. Backspin, 94.83. So the Vice Pro, 94.37. The Pro V1, 94.83. This is tiny amounts. What is that? Not even 50. 47? 40? So something like that? 46? It's nothing. It's so small, it's the basic the same. Peak height is 24.7 yards, so 1 yard lower. Now that could have been due to slightly 1 mile an hour ball speed less, which is most probably the case. And with a 0.4 of a degree, I mean, we're talking picky now, but 51.8 degrees of descent angle against 51.6, 0.2 of a degree, exactly the same. And then carry distance in yards is 92 to the Vice Pro's 93. But, I mean, that is so close, for all intents and purposes, that is exactly the same. 0.6 yards offline, again, that is me. Right, this is where it gets interesting. This is where we will see the largest gap in data, because we're talking about driver now. Now, driver is by far the most unforgiving weapon in the bag. So, go again. G30 LS Tech set at 8 degrees in my Tor shaft. Ball speed 153 with the Vice Pro, the Pro V1 equivalent. Vice Pro 153. Launch angle 15.1, 2 left, 4.6 right, so little tiny cuts, what I normally do with my gaming shot. Now, in this test, I'll just do a little proviso here, right? In this test, I've hit 5 shots each, yeah? And to get a decent amount of understanding of what I was doing, I tried to hit, within reason, 2 fairway finding shots. And then I hit 3, like I wanted to go at it a bit more. Yeah, just a bit more. When I got, I could go for the spin first. The Vice Pro was 2061. The peak height in yards is 37.5. So under my 40, I want to be up sort of like 38, give or take. When it comes to, well, I say 38, anything under 40 and I'm happy. It's just anything over 40 and starting to get a little bit too high. Anything dropping sort of like 35 and under, that's starting to get a bit too low because we're trying to maximise carry. Descent angle, 39.3. For a carry of 273 and bang on, yeah, that's left, right, that's a net of now. So don't worry about dispersion, 273. It's my average yardage. I got one out there at 283 carry, which was my longest. Right, now, same club, different ball, the Pro V1. 154 ball speed, so 1 mile an hour faster than the Vice Pro. Bearing in mind, on the Vice Pro, I have had one miss hit there, and I've left that in. We'll do this data here, and once we finish this bit, I will take that out, and we'll just see what difference it makes. 16.1 degrees in launch. Now, this is the biggest difference I've found so far with the Pro V1 against the Vice Pro, is the Pro V1 seems to launch a fraction higher. That's my... Initially, when I first saw the flights, I thought, is this going a little bit higher? Don't know. Need to get on close data. And in fact, yes, it is. 1 degree. 1 degree. 2.2 left, 6.6 right. That's my little cut again. With a backspin of 2180. Now, the Vice Pro, the 2061. So we're looking at, what, 119 RPM? So there could be there a slight difference, 119 RPM. Peak height, 41.6. Descent angle, 41.8. So it is slightly higher and then slightly steeper than the Vice Pro. We've still got that miss hit in Vice Pro, remember? With a carry of 274, 1 yard further. Okay, 1 yard further. Right, I'm now going to remove the miss hit from the Vice Pro. The Vice Pro now goes up to 155. Launching at 14.6, so launching where I want to be in that 14.5 bracket. 2.5 left, 5.2 right, little cut. Now, 21.51. So I've got all the decent hits in there, so took off that one bad hit. 21.51 in the Vice Pro in backspin against 21.80 of the Pro V1. 29 revs, nothing, absolutely nothing. The difference here is a fact of launch angle. The Pro V1 launches it higher. So, I mean, I'm talking there, we're taking out the miss hit out, that's 1.5 degrees higher. So with it going higher initially, with the same spin, it's now peaking height at 41.6, and then descending at 41.8 for a carry of 274, where the Vice Pro, with that miss hit out, is 21.51, launching at 14.6, but peaking height at 37.6, and then a descent angle 39.5, which is shallower. Carry of 274, exactly the same. Difference being, the Vice Pro, because it's carrying the same, but it's coming in at a more shallower angle, I'm going to get more bounce, bounce, roll out of the Vice Pro than I would do out of the Pro V1, which is coming in higher and then stopping quicker because it's coming in at a steeper descent angle. This information, you can understand now why this video is going to go on for a little bit. Hence the reason why I haven't put the Pro Plus, the Tour, the Drive. If not, this video would go on for a month. But I just wanted to, I can give you my, I've done the same test with the Pro V1X and the Vice Pro Plus, which is the equivalent, and the same results apply. Exactly the same results. So basically, apart from the driver, where the Pro V1X and the Pro V1 launch fractionally higher, which for me, actually, the Vice Pro works better because I'm going to get more bounce, bounce, roll the other end. We're getting the same carry, but we're getting there a different way. Slightly shallower descent angle, and it's going to increase in total distance. So I'll put this down now. I cannot explain just how impressed I am with that Vice ball. Considering it is half the price of a Pro V1, I am absolutely amazed that it is performing the way it does. Durability. Let's go for durability now. I was concerned, obviously, watching some of the other reviews that people have done about, say, the Kirkland ball and with durability issues with that. It was starting to rip up a lot. I use the Pro and the Pro Plus for all the testing. Hits, loads and loads of hits on the simulator inside. I've played 3 or 4 rounds of indoor golf with it for a bit of fun. I then just got my 58 degree wedge, brand new wedge, and just tried to rip their skin to pieces. And I was very pleasantly surprised with the durability of the Vice ball. It's not quite the same as a Pro V or Pro V1X. There is a slight degradation, but I would say it's easily 3/4 as good as a Pro V1 or Pro V1X in durability alone. Basically, when it comes to the durability, within reason, they are very, very similar. The Pro V1 and Pro V1X, yes, it does beat it slightly, but considering the price point of these balls, I cannot tell you how impressed I am with regards to how good these balls are. I'm seriously now considering my own choices in golf ball. I have to buy balls like everyone else. Yes, I get them for a little bit cheaper than most, but I still have to buy the balls. And if I can get the balls substantially cheaper and they do the exact same thing, the only difference is one says Vice on it, one says Titleist on it. That's it. What else is there to say? The ball feels the same as the Pro V1 Pro and the Pro V1X, the Pro Plus. So the feel is identical. The performance is identical. The durability is nearly as good as the like for like. I'm struggling not to recommend these balls completely. I think they are amazing balls. I love these balls, and I am now seriously considering changing manufacturers. So I urge you to test these balls. If you can, find some to test. It is well worth testing these balls. There are different types of balls. This is just the Pro and the Pro Plus, the ones I use. They do the tour and the drive as well for more of a, like the distance kind of ball, two-piece, etc. They've got a different cover. That's not the urethane cover. It's more like the distance cover for pure durability, etc. But I would urge you to test these balls. These balls really do, well, they say what on the actual advertising, they do what they say. So hope you liked the review. If you did, click the like button below. Sorry it's been a little bit more drawn out, but you can appreciate with all the information that Vice is saying that they are as good as they are, it is well worth really drilling down into the nitty gritty of the data to see if they are. So hope you liked the video. If you did, click the like button below, comment below with anything you'd like to see on the channel, and don't forget to subscribe.
Don't forget to subscribe and follow me on my other social media. On Periscope, search Ask Golf Nut, and on Twitter, search @AskGolfNut. Thanks for watching.